La mesma influência que ha tenido a expulsão de Pepe 2 anos atrás. A este nível competitivo, a este nível de equilíbrio, jogador menos durante muito tempo cambia muita coisa.
To what extent do you feel that the sending off, the decision to send the player off, had on the eventual result of the tie? I think that it had the same influence as the decision 2 years ago to send Pepe off in the semi-final. I think when you're talking about football at this level, with such a fine balance between two equally matched teams, playing with one man down for such a long period in a game is going to change a lot in a game.
Compañero Roberto de Ayamacet, cuando pasó esa expulsión a la que usted hace referencia, usted fue muy crítico en determinadas ocasiones con el organismo, con la UEFA. ¿Hoy es igual de crítico o simplemente lo considera un error arbitral normal?
No, yo soy crítico con los jugadores que simulan. Yo soy crítico con los jugadores que empujan a los árbitros para decisiones equivocadas. Y afortunadamente para mí, no es el caso. Existe un contacto bastante fuerte entre Nani y Arbeloa y después el árbitro ha decidido por roja, a lo mejor puede haber decidido por amarilla, pero nosotros, honestos, nosotros hemos hecho nuestro partido y ahora mismo Ferguson me ha dicho eso mismo, no del Real Madrid, de los jugadores del Real Madrid no podemos decir absolutamente nada porque honestidad y fair play, y eso para mí es importante.
¿Qué expulsión era la otra que referiste, perdón?
Pepe.
Sí. Referring back to the sending off of Pepe, you're angry, you made comments against UEFA about the whole scenario. Would you do the same if it was the other way around tonight, or would you just say it was a bad decision that went to a bad refereeing decision generally that you get along the way? No, I think that I would always criticise I would do the same. I think it's when it's talking about players who are simulating or feigning injury, if you like. And I can say for certain in this case that Arbeloa was not doing that. He was not feigning injury. It was quite strong contact between from Nani on him, and he was shown a red. It could have been maybe on other occasions you could have seen a yellow for the same offence. But the most important thing that we've been very honest in this, and Sir Alex Ferguson has just said the same to me, you know, Real Madrid, we played our game, we got on with things, and we've just been talking there. And I think that United have no complaints about Real Madrid role in it at all.
Sir Alex, did you promote to say that you know it's staying to speak as you're so angry? Can you understand his anger, and was he still angry when he spoke to you?
When I meet him in privacy. It was better before the match because we were there 45 minutes together. And it's better. Before the match is much better. Now, no time because of press, just enough time to change a few words.
La pregunta refirió al hecho de que Ferguson no acudió a la rueda porque, según my feeling, no estaba en condiciones para venir. ¿Mantuviste una conversación con él y quedaba enfadado todavía? ¿Qué le parecía? Bueno, no hubo mucho tiempo por todo lo de los medios después del partido, pero tuve la suerte de pasar 45 minutos con él antes del partido. Muy bien, siempre está mejor hablar y pasar un rato antes de los partidos porque después no hay tiempo. En privado, hemos pasado tiempo en privado.
¿Come in?
Para mí siempre ha justificado. La prensa puede tener otro tipo de visión. Yo creo que Eloy ha traído al equipo características que el equipo no tenía. El Manchester ha jugado un partido defensivo fantástico. Los 11 jugadores trabajando increíble y tácticamente súper organizados, nos han creado muchísimas dificultades. Y pienso que después, jugando con Modric, independientemente de que ellos estaban con un jugador menos, pero Luka ha traído creatividad, dinámica, más movimiento, más pensamiento vertical, pensamiento más rápido, porque ejecuta más rápido. Y pienso que Luka ha cambiado un poco la dirección del partido.
People have maybe questioned the signing of Modric months ago for Madrid. Do you think now, with his intervention tonight, do you think Modric has justified his existence? Do you think he needed anything to prove to us or to you? No, I've always been justified in bringing Modric to the club. Maybe you guys have a different opinion, but I've always been fully convinced he was a great player, and today he brought something different, irrespective or independent from the fact that he was playing against 10 men. I think that we needed something different. You know, Manchester United tactically were very, very well set up. They defended, all 11 people defended very, very well, stoutly. Made it difficult for us. And Modric just brought that extra little bit of speed to our forward thinking, movement. He got the ball forward more quickly and more vertically. And I think he made the difference. If it had been against 11, he would have still made a difference.
Jose, what are the decisions to say no one? What's the best way for commanders? Is it to speak publicly about them? Is it to try to approach the referee, or the alternative to speak to the referee about it?
If somebody can cry, I'm the first one. I'm the first one, because my history is not to play against them. My history is to play with 10. And my history is to play with 10 in semifinals, not in last 16 or quarterfinals, semifinals. So I try to be honest, and be honest is to say that in my opinion, the best team lost. But that's football. When we were against 10, we played very well for 10 minutes. You know, we created new problems. Ozil White and Luka and Kaká both behind Higuain, I think, was a new problem for them that they couldn't solve with 10 men. So we deserve credit for that. And after the two goals, I know what is Old Trafford. I know what is Sir Alex Ferguson as a leader, what he can do to his team by the mental point of view. So I could guess that the end of the match would be what we had. And in that part, we couldn't control the game by possession, which frustrated me, because with one player more and with the midfield, with the triangle very clear, Alonso, Khedira and Modric, I thought, plus Cristiano coming for the ball, plus Kaká coming for the ball, I thought we should control the match with ball possession. We couldn't. And in that moment, we had Diego Lopez that gave us the victory. And to have a fantastic goalkeeper that gives you the victory, I think is also part of the game, because De Gea was the man of the match in Madrid. And today the man of the match was Diego Lopez.
¿Qué se puede hacer? ¿Cuáles son las alternativas para un entrenador frustrado al final del partido? ¿Qué es la mejor manera? ¿Hablar en público? ¿Hablar con la UEFA? ¿Enfadarse? Bueno, para mí, yo soy, muchas veces soy el primero en gritar, llorar, casi quejar. Jugamos con 10. Pero lo que pasa con nosotros, normalmente resulta que jugamos con 10 en semifinales, no en octavos o cuartos. Yo podría decir que hoy día, esta noche, perdió el mejor equipo, esta noche. Pero también hay que decir que son cosas del fútbol. El fútbol puede ser así a veces. Nosotros jugamos muy bien durante 10 minutos. Los cambios que habíamos hecho, poniendo a Ozil por la banda y con Kaká y Luka justo detrás de Higuaín, no podían con esto durante 10 minutos. y dominamos en ese periodo. Pero yo conozco Old Trafford, conozco el líder que es Sir Alex Ferguson, y sabía que iba a remontar, a intentar hacer una gran remontada durante los últimos momentos del partido. Y al final queríamos controlar con un triángulo en el medio, justo en frente de nuestra zaga, pero no pudimos porque ellos tenían más posesión que nosotros queríamos. Pero al final de todo, como De Gea había hecho en el Bernabéu, y son por eso, están ahí, aquí por eso, los porteros nos salvó, nos ganó, nos dio la victoria Diego López, dando prueba de que es un gran portero y lo hizo su tarea.
Hacemos dos últimas preguntas, last two questions. Okay. No, sorry.
Hola, señor Modelo, la cuenta de Telecinco. Lo ha dicho en una entrevista y lo ha vuelto a repetir ahora. No se ha clasificado el mejor equipo. ¿Usted qué cree que hubiera pasado sin la expulsión de Nani? ¿Cómo estaba llevando el Madrid un partido en ese
momento? No, ellos han defendido muy bien con 11 jugadores. Nos han, se puede decir, controlado durante el primer tiempo. En el segundo tiempo yo he hecho el cambio de Modric, y en el momento que marcamos el empate iba a poner a Benzema, y no iba a quitar a Higuaín, iba a jugarlo todo, iba a arriesgar con todo, porque es lo que tenía que hacer en ese momento. Por eso yo no digo que 11 contra 11 no pudiera suceder lo que ha sucedido, pero la realidad de las cosas es que con 10 hay durante momentos, principalmente en los primeros minutos, unas dudas que se pueden generar, y nosotros hemos ayudado a que esas dudas apareciesen, porque hemos abierto Ozil a la banda, hemos obligado a Evra a quedarse abierto, hemos metido Modric en la posición de, acabamos con la posición de Khedira y creamos la posición de Modric junto a Kaká detrás de Higuaín, y nosotros también tenemos culpa de las dificultades que les hemos peleado. La historia también está llena de partidos en que equipos con 10 se consiguen aguantar, también hemos tenido mérito. Pero a mí lo que más me frustra de verdad es que con 10 jugadores contra 11 y ganando 2-1, tenemos que controlar el partido. Diego no tiene que ser el mejor en campo, Diego no tiene que tocar balón. 11 contra 10, tenemos que tener balón. Hemos creado, yo he metido Pepe lateral para crear otra vez el centrocampo de 3. He metido Xavi con Khedira, con Modric, estabilidad en el equipo, estabilidad posicional. En ese momento yo espero control total del partido. Y al final, Diego ha tenido que parar lo que ha parado.
What do you think would have happened if the sending off hadn't taken place? How do you think Madrid would have coped with the situation 11 against 11? And what do you think might have happened? Well, I think I was planning some changes in the second half anyway. For example, after we equalised, I was about to put Benzema on.
And before we equalised?
Before we equalised, sorry. Before we equalised, thank God. And I was going to go for Broke, with Benzema going up front and playing him alongside Higuain, not exchanging him for. But fortunately, we managed to score soon after the sending off, and then we managed to create doubts for Manchester United with the 11 against 10. Because quite often, when you've got 10, there are plenty of cases in history where teams have hung on with 10 men and maybe gained strength from having 10 men. But I think it was important that, you know, we reacted. I moved Modric forward to play just behind Higuain, alongside, as I mentioned before, Ozil out on the wing. But really, to sum up what really kind of frustrates me, I think we did create problems. We took hold of the situation ourselves, and there's nothing to say that we couldn't have done that 11 against 11. But what does frustrate me from how we played after we went 2-1 up is that we didn't manage to keep the ball enough. We should have, with the man extra and with the three back in midfield, and put Pepe back to right back to maintain our normal three in the centre of the park, we should have been keeping the ball. We shouldn't have to be relying upon Diego López to do what he did and win the game for us.
Last question.
I think Sir Alex won the right over the years of every decision is correct, and every decision should never have a question mark in front. He's the best, he's the top, he creates an incredible history. You are nobody, I am nobody to put a question mark in front. And this team was very well organized. Defensively was fantastic. And I think he did great. I think he did a great job. Ronaldo, I think mentally not easy. I played Stamford Bridge, not easy. I played in Porto, not easy. One day I go back to San Siro to play against Inter, not easy. One day I go back to the Bernabeu to play against Real, not easy. So Cristiano, not easy. Not easy, mentally is not easy.
Dos preguntas. Despedimos primero.
Chao.